From our studios in Nashville, Tennessee, the Not-So-Newlywed Game. And now, here's your host, Abbott Phillips.
Thank you, thank you, thank you, and welcome to the Not-So-Newlywed Game. Let's meet our players. Our first contestant's wife told us she was smitten on their first date the moment she laid eyes on him in his, quote, dad jeans. Those are her words, not mine. You know him, you love him, Mr. Ben Shapiro. His wife said that outside of politics and media, his dream job would be as an ice cream selling fisherman, Mr. Matt Walsh. Our next contestant's wife told us his biggest pet peeve is when people just text him. That's Michael Knowles. And our final contestant's wife said if he could have a $1,000 gift card to anywhere, it would be to a used bookstore. The leader of Clavenon, the Clavenator, his royal Claveness, Mr. Andrew Claven. All right, now let's get straight to the questions and get into it. As you know, gentlemen, you'll be answering these questions as you predict your wife answered them before the show. So your wife's filled out the questionnaires. You guys are gonna see how well you know your wives and how well they know you. If her answer matches your prediction, you then get 5 points towards a very special grand prize that's been selected especially for you. So nice to have you all with us. Here's your first question for 5 points. What would you say is his most persistent and annoying habit that he knows drives you crazy, but yet he continues to do anyway? Ben, we're gonna start with you on this one. What do you think your wife views as your most consistent annoying habit that you continue to do?
I'm gonna go ignoring her while I'm talking, while she's talking to me, because I'm busy doing other things. I'm on my phone or I'm reading or something.
We're gonna go on next to Matt. Matt, what do you got here?
Anything that makes a noise that she doesn't like, maybe scraping plates. She accuses me sometimes of blinking too loudly, so any sort of noise.
Any sort of noise. I like that. Very broad. Gives you a better chance of answering correctly there. All right, Michael, to you. What do you think?
I'm torn between I leave my clothes everywhere and I show up late to everything, but I am going to say my wife answers that I leave my clothes everywhere.
Closing out with Mr. Claven. Andrew, what do you got?
Well, aside from the fact that I keep coming home every night, which I think really annoys her, I would say it's probably the fact that I do a perfect imitation of listening to her and then have no idea what she told me was going to happen tomorrow.
All right, I'm seeing some common themes emerging here from all of you. I like it. We're going to get now to your wife's answers. For number one, Mrs. Shapiro's answer. She said, not hearing me or anyone when he's reading or writing something, emails, Twitter, book. He'll literally be typing something on the computer, but looking at me straight in the eyes. I'll think I'm having a full conversation, but all the while he's registered none of what are said. This part at the end does burn a little bit. She said, thankfully, our daughter now does the same thing to all of us, so he knows how it feels. But Ben, you got the answer right.
Yeah, and that is fact check true. My daughter, chip off the old block right there.
We've passed the fact check. I like it. Matt Walsh. Your wife said, quote, when he blinks his dry eyes, I can hear the loud blinking and it drives me crazy. Clearly, he hasn't heard of eye drops.
You thought I was joking. She really can hear me blink, okay? That's what I'm dealing with here.
Next up, Michael Knowles. Your wife answered, quote, leaving clothes on the floor, wet towels on the bed, general messiness. Again, you answer clothing there, so we're going to give you points on that. Drew, you said you do a perfect imitation of listening. Your wife said, stinky and unhealthy smoking cigars.
Oh, yes, she does hate those cigars. That's true.
I have to say, Drew, I'm a little offended that the worst quality that your wife finds in you is me. That's very offensive, but yeah, whatever, that's okay.
She didn't want to come out and say that, but that's obviously the case.
Question number two, would he rather do laundry or do dishes? A little more straightforward here. Ben, we're going to start with you again.
Dishes.
All right, Matt.
It's kind of a trick question because I hate them both equally. But I guess I would say I would rather do the dishes. But I'd prefer if she just did both of the things.
Michael, to you.
Dishes. It's no question. I'm not sure in our entire marriage if I've ever done a full load of laundry. So I think I have that one.
I like it. All right, Drew.
Well, this is a trick question because I have not done anything around the house for 40 years. I've been a completely useless. But it's clear that if I had to choose, it would have to be dishes because she was just out of town for a month and I actually called her up and said, how do you do laundry? So I think dishes is the only thing I know how to do.
All right, to the answers. Ben, you answered dishes. Mrs. Shapiro said, I'm not sure Ben knows how to do laundry, so I'll go with the dishes, which he does quite often. And she threw in a little thanks, hun. Matt, you answered I hate them both, but dishes. Your wife said dishes. And she also threw in, he doesn't know how to do the laundry. Again, being thrown under the bus.
True.
Michael, you answered dishes. Your wife said neither, but if there was a gun to his head, he would choose dishes. And Drew, finally, you answered, I don't do anything but the dishes if I had to. And your wife put, again in all caps here, very forceful answer, since he doesn't know how to do laundry, as we learned when I was out of town for several weeks, I'm guessing it's the dishes. And on to the next question, number three, what is the tastiest dish that he can cook? Ben, what do you think your wife loves of your cooking?
I think that she's gonna go hash browns. I make excellent hash browns.
Next up, Matt, what do you think?
I am actually a phenomenal cook. I make everything. I'm a fantastic chef. We're a progressive household, so I do most of the cooking in our house. But my best dish would have to be chili.
All right, Michael, what do you think?
You know, early on when Elisa and I were dating back in like the 80s, back when we were like 3 years old, I actually did most of the cooking. I even showed my wife how to cook a little bit, even though now she does 100% of the cooking. So the only thing I cook anymore is pasta a la carbonara, either with spaghetti or bucatini. So I think by default, that's the best thing I make because it's the ham, egg, and cheese of the Italians.
It sounds like a good bet. Drew, what do you think?
I have exactly two culinary abilities. One is to ask my wife what's for dinner, and the other is to make an omelet. So it's got to be the omelet, I think.
All right, we're going to get right into the answers. Ben, you said hash browns. Correct. And your wife said, Ben makes excellent hash browns. He has definitely mastered the perfect combination of buttery and crunchy. You guys, spot on. There you go. Matt, you answered chili. Your wife put one word, chili. Spot on. You guys are two for two right now. I'm actually impressed that you guys are getting some of these answers so accurate. Michael, you answered pasta carbonara. Carbonara. I'm not an Italian like you, but your wife put carbonara or beef stroganoff. Look at you guys. Drew, I'm going to be honest. You're the only one that got this wrong. And technically, your wife gave a little bit of a trick answer because she said, here is Drew's recipe. Pick up phone, open Grubhub, order whatever he wants.
Well, that's something. So, she missed my omelet. I taught her how to make an omelet. I'm hurt. I'm deeply hurt. Although she said it's quite accurate, but still.
It does sound accurate. All right, so 3 for 4 from you fellas on that one. On to question number 4. What superpower would he most like to have?
Maybe flying?
Flying, all right. Matt, what do you think?
This is a question I haven't really thought much about because I'm not a child. Maybe... What does Aquaman do? Does he ride a dolphin? I think I'd take, because with the beard and the dolphin, I'd probably take that. I'd go with whatever Aquaman does.
All right, Michael?
You know, it's just the issue here is my wife is pure as the newly driven snow, so her mind would never go to the gutter like mine would. I'm going to say the power to pause time. This is partially because I'm always late to things and I'm always behind on it. So I'm going to say pausing time, then I could get stuff done. That's my answer.
Okay, Drew, last and not least, what do you think?
Well, she would never guess the real answer, which is to cause my enemies to burst into flame just by thinking about it. but she would probably just say flying, I guess.
Okay, this one you guys did not perform as well on. I'm going to be honest, you guys were 0 for 4. Ben, you answered flying. Your wife gives a long answer here. She's clearly put a lot of thought into this. She says, I think Ben would love to have a power related to the control of time. He's always had a fascination with it. Not necessarily time travel, but maybe being able to freeze or stop time so he could enjoy every second, particularly with regards to watching our kids grow up so fast. Ben, your wife making you sound just like a really good guy here.
That is a better answer than my answer, for sure.
Matt, you answered Aquaman. Your wife, she said super strength. I think Aquaman has super strength.
That counts. Because he's got super strength, doesn't he?
I'm getting in my head that does not count.
No. Aquaman is not, as a DC guy, no. Aquaman does not have super strength. He happens to be a strong person, but his power is to talk to fish. Come on.
His power is magnified underwater because things are less heavy.
So when he's fighting the giant squid or shark, whatever he does, that doesn't take super strength?
He's got the trident. The trident really helps him a lot in that. It's not like a physical one-on-one, like... brute
force. I could pull up a picture of Aquaman right now. He looks like a strong guy to me.
Oh, no. He's a very strong guy, dude. I mean, Jason Momoa is a monster. But that's just because he's a monster of a human. Like, in real life, he's a monster.
Okay. Well, who's the judge here? Who's deciding?
I'm going to decide, and we're going to give you 2.5 out of 5 points for that because I do think Aquaman has super strength. There's no other way for him to be fighting those creatures that he's fighting.
This is rigged.
So we're giving 2.5 points for that one. Michael, you're up next. You says, pause time. Your wife said, be in two places at once. And she also added something that allows him to smoke even more cigars.
That's true. Bigger lungs. That's true. I should have guessed bigger lungs.
Drew, you answered flying, and your wife chose immortality.
Oh, yeah, that's true. That is. Well, I think I already have that. I seem to have been around forever, so I say, yeah.
Question number five. If you were a celebrity couple, who would you be? Who do you guys think your wives view you as? Ben, first to you.
Yeah, I feel like we're totally going to get this one wrong. Because my frame of reference is utterly different from hers. She cares about some celebrity stuff, and I do not. So I'm going to say John and Abigail Adams, and we're going to be completely wrong.
All right. Matt, what do you think?
She'd probably answer some HGTV. She's obsessed with HGTV. So I don't know if they have celebrity couples on that network, but somebody in that realm, maybe.
Okay, HGTV. That's a pretty broad answer, but
that's my game here, if you haven't noticed.
We got to come on, aim small, miss small. All right, Michael, what do you think?
Ronald and Nancy, final answer.
Andrew, what do you got?
Oh man, this is impossible. I would say probably Macbeth and Lady Macbeth, but I think it's Henry II, you know, Peter O'Toole and Catherine Hepburn in The Lion in Winter.
I'm not sure whether she would
say that or she would say Henry II and what's her name? I can't remember the queen's name, but those are the characters.
All right. Gentlemen, you were 2 for 4 on this one. Ben, you took a wild guess on John and Abigail Adams, and it paid off. That is what your wife gave. She gave another lengthy description here. I'm going to read this. She said, I like to think we're like John and Abigail Adams. They had an amazing love story. They were married young. I was 20, Ben 24. They raised 5 kids together, and even though they endured long separations, their 1,000 letters to each other demonstrated their unwavering love and passion. And she added at the end, Ben used to dress up as John Adams when he was a little boy, which is super cute.
Wow, big win to my wife right there. Wow, I did not see that coming. She really, you know, sometimes even my expectations for her are high, as she is, of course, the world's second greatest doctor after Dr. Jill Biden. But still, my expectations were surpassed there. Well done, sweetheart. Well done.
Matt, you're up next. You chose an HGTV couple. Your wife actually chose, I don't know how to say this, Lorelei Gilmore and Luke Danes from The Gilmore Girls.
What? she wasn't working with me on that one because there's no way I was going to possibly answer that.
Do you watch The Gilmore Girls?
I've gotten absorbed into a 5-6 hour marathon on occasion, but that's it.
Michael, you answered Ronald and Nancy Reagan. The actual answer she gave was Lucy and Ricky Ricardo from I Love Lucy.
That's a better answer.
Do you feel like that's accurate?
She's going to have some splaining to do when we get home, but fair enough.
Okay. And I was actually incorrect. I said 2 out of 4 were correct. Ben was the only one who got this wrong because, Drew, you chose Lion and Winter Couple. It was actually her answer, Lady and the Tramp.
Yeah, that's a better answer. That is a better answer. I would never have come up with that, but that is quite correct, yeah.
And the final question for you fellows, what is a movie that he will watch over and over again if it's on TV? Or on Netflix, whatever it is. Movies. Ben, what do you think your wife gave?
That's very difficult because we watch a lot of movies together. Maybe The Dark Knight. Either that or Interstellar. Maybe she knows I'm a Nolan guy.
All right. Matt?
I'm going to say her answer was a Hollywood film from the last 50 years.
Too broad.
No, is that too broad?
Come on.
I mean, the actual answer is like Goodfellas probably, but I don't think she would say that. So I don't know. We recently talked about A Christmas Story, and I said I can watch that every time it comes on. So I'm going to say maybe that was her answer.
Okay, Christmas Story. Michael.
There is no question, the greatest movie ever made, Me, Myself, and Irene.
All right, another quick answer there. And Drew.
Well, I'm going to give the real answer because in the hopes that she knows this, it's The Godfather. I cannot turn that movie off. All I have to do is switch the channel and see it, and 2 hours of my life instantly vanish.
You guys did pretty well on this one. Ben, you answered Dark Knight. Your wife answered, I think it would be Amadeus and Lives of Others.
She actually knows the correct answers. Once again, this is my problem. It's soft bigotry of low expectations here. I definitely should have gone, higher brow because she knew the correct answers. Those are my two favorite movies. So, yeah.
All right, Matt, you answered A Christmas Story. Your wife said any Western movie. She went broad on this one too, and you still missed it. Mm.
Yeah.
Is there a favorite Western in there though?
You know, but the classic one I grew up watching with my dad was Shane. So great I'd movie. Probably still say that's my favorite Western.
Michael, you answered Me, Myself, and Irene very quickly. Your wife answered Me, Myself, and Irene as well.
It's obvious.
What about that movie?
How long do we have? I mean, is this going to be a 7-hour broadcast to delve the depths of the Farrelly brothers? And I could go on and on and on, but every aspect is brilliant. There's never been a movie that has matched it.
Drew, you answered The Godfather. It's tough. Your wife said Roadhouse, but right afterwards she said, although second choice, The Godfather.
Yeah, those are both absolutely true. Those are the movies. I once watched Roadhouse twice in two nights. Because she was out of town. Just kept playing. But those are the two right answers, yeah.
All right. I have tallied the scores. The judges have convened because I'm the only judge. And we have a tie right now between Michael and Ben. But fear not, because we have a tiebreaker that we're going to go off of right now. So the tiebreaker, gentlemen, just for you two, what is his most commonly repeated phrase around the house?
Did I say specifically in the house? So this wouldn't be like a catchphrase. Wouldn't be like what you're talking about, Willis, or something that I would say.
Probably not. No, this would be in the house. Your phrases.
What you talking about, sweet little Lisa? I would say, "Hey, girl." I'm going to go very, very broad. I think that is the phrase I would say the most, even though it's not the most memorable.
Okay, Ben.
So this changes over time. It depends which child has been had most recently because there are catchphrases for each child. So right now we have a very small baby and she's been deemed the queen of the household by me and others. So right now it's the queen, probably.
We're going to start with Michael. Your wife said probably something inappropriate in Italian, but I'll go with, quote, yeah, kid.
Yeah, kid is another one. Yeah, it's another. Yeah. All right.
What's the context of yeah, kid? When do you use that?
Kid, well, obviously it's a very broad statement. It's whenever anything good happens, or like if Me, Myself, and Irene happens to be on TV and I'm watching, like, yeah, kid, yeah, but I lost it. I lost that one fair and square. I'm glad she didn't go into the inappropriate things because those would probably be the real answer.
Yeah, I'm glad she didn't either, especially the ones in Italian. And Ben, you answered the queen. I think we're going to give you this one because your wife said the first thing she wrote down, Queenie.
Yep.
Wow.
She put, I'm going to give the full answer. Queenie, Mr. Jeebs.
Mr. Jeebs, that's
Lemur.
Right, yeah.
She said those are the incredibly random yet adorable nicknames for our three children. Queenie's our 11-month-old baby, Mr. Jeebs, our 4-year-old son, and Lemur, our 7-year-old daughter. Ben is constantly chasing after them and throwing them around, so I hear those names quite often.
This is what's and Michael, all your catchphrases are going to change once your son is old enough for you to actually care about him.
Well, you know, it'll only be inappropriate Italian phrases because presumably he won't know that right away, but we'll find out.
I actually want to hear from Matt and Drew on this one as well because we have your wives' answers here. Just you know, not for the competition's sake, but Matt and Drew, what do you guys think the answers were?
Yeah, the most common thing I have no idea what she's going to say, and I'm a little worried, but the most common thing I find myself saying in the house is like, stop climbing that, because I have a 4-year-old boy and a 7-year-old boy and they're always climbing things. So I say that probably 17 times a day, stop climbing that.
Your wife actually answered simply, you're canceled.
I don't really say that in the house as much though. I do cancel my family, but I usually do it on the air, not in the house.
And Drew, what do you think?
Well, I know what I often say. I would never, ever say this to my wife, but while watching TV, I am frequently heard to say, that's crap. So I don't know if that's what she would say.
She said, never give up.
I do say that. That's true. That's true. That's when I'm actually being a human being, but that's so rare. I counted that up.
All right, gentlemen, with the high score of 25, Mr. Ben Shapiro, you are the Not So Newlywed Game grand prize winner. And now, as the winner of the Not So Newlywed Game, here is a special prize chosen just for you. Just in time for Valentine's Day, you will get 1 dozen red roses delivered to your wife.
The perfect way to say I love you on Valentine's Day, and it's all hers since you're today's winner on the Not So Newlywed Game.
What a thrilling victory for me and for my wife. I'd just like to note at this time that Andrew Klavan, who has been married the longest, knows the least about his wife of any person I have ever heard of, who's been married this long.
Well, I've gotten to know my wife. Would she hang around? I mean,
that is fair. I've gotten to know my wife rather well over the years, which just makes me more grateful that she has, in fact, stuck around long enough to know the answers to those questions. Gang, marriage is wonderful. Kids are simultaneously wonderful and horrifying. But all of this should be good reason for you to look at us and say to yourselves, I could be like those people in 10 to 40 years. Wait, did I just make the case for marriage or not? I don't know. But get married. It's good for society.
We will wrap it up there. Gentlemen, thank you so much for joining us. We hope all of you have a wonderful Valentine's Day full of love and happiness and all that great stuff. Thank you so much for tuning in. I'm Cabot Phillips with The Daily Wire. See you guys next time.